What is the difference between MVC, MVP, MVVM, famously known as MVW, model view, whatever? Hello friends, today we'll look into what is the difference between different architectural patterns like model view presenter, model view controller, and model view view model. To properly understand these architectural patterns, we have to go back a little bit in the history, how we started our development, what kind of problems did we face, and how did we handle these, how did we use these patterns to handle those problems. So when we started coding, the pattern we followed were big ball of mud or spaghetti code, which means we did not follow any architecture. We opened a window forms, opened a control, and wrote all the code. Business logic, data access logic, user interface logic, everywhere there. So as long there was only Windows platform, it worked very well. We have to deploy application on Windows. Then what happened? Web came. Now everybody expected same application to be available on the web. So we have a logic which was being used by Windows forms, and we have to deploy similar application on web. So it didn't make sense that we duplicate same data access and business logic there. So the good practice came, okay, you need to extract the business logic out of your presentation layer so that your presentation layer is lightly coupled. It was window forms. Today it's a web-based HTML forms, or web in ASP.NET we have web forms. So as we took out the business logic a little bit, there was still a lot of logic where presentation and model will work together, and they were written inside the UI, and this code was not usable. It was very difficult to write test. Initially, writing test for user interface technology was not easy. So let's go into model view presenter. So what happened in window forms or ASP.NET web forms, it was very difficult to write business. It was very difficult to write test, automated test, because the presentation technology, you would have session variable, which made writing test very, very difficult to manipulate. So there came this MVP design pattern. What happened in, you had a just, your web form would be just an interface to delegate all the functionality to the presenter. So presenter played with your model, which were business objects. It played with the model. Okay, you have inventory, you have to get inventory, order, prepare the order, and present this order to the view. So this view was just delegating all the events to this presenter. And presenter was doing all the processing. This presenter has a lot of code related to UI. It was dependent on UI. So it was not a great pattern, you can see, because it was in this, the presenter has to know lot about UI. There came MVC pattern, model view controller. In model view controller pattern, what happens? The first input goes to the controller, and controllers then manipulates the model. Okay, get the order, whether this order is inventory, it's processed, and gives order, and then it chooses the view and gives the model to the view so that view can show that order information. So let's see what are the differences here between model view presenter and model view controller. The first obvious difference is the control in MVC, controller decides the view. You have a control that using routing intercepts the coming request by the URL. Whereas in MVP web, let's take ASP.NET web forms. ASP.NET web form decides okay which web form it's showing, how web form is being rendered. So basically, controls goes to the first web form, the view, and it passes controls to the presenter. Wherever in MVC, controller is the one which gets the first input, and it does all the processing, all the manipulation of model. So another big difference is controller has no knowledge of the view. Controller is not dependent, okay, what is being shown on the view, how to manipulate, how to do the mapping between view and the model. Whereas in MVP, presenter is doing everything. It's a presenter knows about the view. It's preparing the order, is preparing order and showing to the view. MVC examples, ASP.NET MVC is example of MVC pattern, obviously. And presenter model was more popular in ASP.NET web forms. So let's come to view model, model view, view model. So view model is geared towards more Silverlight, those kind of technologies, where view model is preparing the model so that it can be binded to the view. There's one more other reason is like I can see I use view model. I'll show you how I use view model in my architecture. So in a lot of time, our business, the way web. You may have different presentations technologies. You may be using web forms for mobile. You have another user interface called mobile. Mobile may be showing very less information. So if you are tying your business objects based on what are the interface you have. So you don't want to tie, okay, because you want keep your business model independent of presentation technology, because presentation technology can change. So here comes the view model. You may be showing very less information on the mobile, but whereas a lot of information on the web forms. And you don't want to create business objects, one for mobile, one for web technology. You don't want your business object based on some presentation technology. So here comes a view model. Generally what I do is from the controller we generate view models which view use to bind to generate the views. The controller talks to the data access layer, and controller is responsible for talking to the data access layer, prepare the model, and finally gives the view model to the view. That way your information showing on web or mobile is different than your business objects. Both can change independently. You don't have to have different versions of your business objects based on what are the platform you are using. So friends, today we discussed model view presenter, model view controller, and model view view model. So if you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to this channel for your regular updates. Also connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn. If you like small summaries of the video, I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.